sacrifice. Future generations will know. The conflicts and the past, the loss that followed every gun blast, every name, every grave, every battle brought us peace in future fields. We pledge to share your story forever, so that such loss and heartache shall never, never again cause so many to die. We plead with God on high. We shall not be silent. We shall do you proud in future fields. We remember the conflict. The loss that followed every gun's blast, every name, every grave, every battle brought us peace in future fields. Every name, every grave, every battle brought us peace in future fields.
Sophie's poem has touched so many hearts, I think locally and nationally actually. When she won Poppyscotland's Future of Remembrance competition, we were just absolutely ecstatic. So lovely how the community got behind her so well. Our poem was in a local coffee shop and we had lots of comments from people who'd spotted it. One gentleman, who's a member of the Legion Scotland, had asked if Sophie would like to put her copy of the poem and the War Memorial. In Trident on Armistice Day, and she told him that she'd be honest to do so. So her poem, In Future Fields, is really Sophie's tribute to all those soldiers who lost their lives for our freedom. Her inspiration came from John McCrae's poem, In Flanders Fields, written in 1915. In Future Fields was Sophie's way really of giving soldiers back their voice, including that of her great-grandpa who died in the war. So Sophie's song, In Future Fields, is her message of hope and peace, in the hope that no more soldiers' graves shall lie in future fields.
When people my age think of combat, I think we mainly think of adults in the armed forces. But I've learned that actually in the beginning of the First World War, back in 1914, there were nowhere near enough men eligible to fight. There was a shortage of men because of this, so boys as young as 14 and 15 had to join up. Their ages were overlooked, well, because rule of thumb, there was, if they were big enough and strong enough, then why not volunteer to fight for their country? One boy, George Mayer, was just 13 when he was sent to the Somme. He fought alongside a boy, just 12, who had to be lifted over to see the top of the trenches. Then there's Jack Cornwall. Though barely 16, he won the Victoria Cross for bravery during the Battle of Jutland in May 1916. He was on board the HMS Chester when it was attacked by German ships. Though seriously wounded, he remained at one of the ships until the attack had ended, but later died of his wounds. So today we remember people the same age as me, who were just like you and I, who were just born at a different time when the world was unstable. What happened to the people who were in the First World War was so inhumane and so shocking that the First World War was remembered as the war to end all wars. In their final moment, they thought of the humble worries and delicate fears of loved ones and of the hopes and dreams.
So I'd just like to say congratulations to Sophie. We are so proud of you at St Patrick's. When I heard your song just last week, it made the hairs on the ends of my arms stand on end. It is so beautiful and poetic, and I hope that you raise lots of money for Poppyscotland as you intended. You have a heart of gold, and we absolutely are so proud of you here.
Hi Sophie, Mrs McGarver here. Just want to wish you a huge congratulations on all your hard work and efforts. Who knew a small activity in class would grow to such a wonderful big thing for you? Congratulations again, and I'm sure this will be the first of many wonderful things for you in your life for the future. Bye.
Hi Sophie, a huge congratulations from us all at St Patrick's. We're immensely proud of you and we're just absolutely delighted. Go and shine, as we know you will.
Sophie, hi from sunny Tenerife. Just to say congratulations on winning the Poppy Scotland competition with your fabulous poem, which has in turn been made into a song. Super proud of you. Well done.
Hi Sophie, Future Fields, a stunning poem and now a fabulous song. Congratulations and well done from all of us.
Hi Sophie, massive congratulations on winning the Poppy Scotland competition with your fantastic poem and now song. I've always known you're a wee star and this just goes to prove it even more. Congratulations.
Hello Sophie, and congratulations on your incredible achievement from all of us at Centre Stage. We are so proud of you and we can't wait to see you again soon.